the political violence, or rather the violence that have been spreading out throughout the Northwest, and of course an intervention by the ANC's highest decision-making body, the NEC, as well as the ANC's top six, including the president of the ANC. Right now, I'm joined by the Premier of the Northwest, Supra Mahumapelo. Thank you so much, Premier, for joining us this evening.
Hi, Aldrin. Let me also take this opportunity to greet the viewers of SABC.
Premier, before we get into this discussion, what I first want to do is go back to a clip, which is a quote, rather, from you from this afternoon or this morning when you're delivering your budget speech, in it where you indicated that you will be sending a letter to the Speaker later on this week. Let's just quickly take a listen and then we'll discuss it further.
The Speaker will receive a commitment in writing before Friday this week, in ensuring that we create the essence of the absence of presence.
Premier, what exactly will be in this letter?
Well, Aldrin and the viewers of the SABC, we are already at a stage where we are beyond predictions of what is supposed to happen. Tomorrow, I have convened a press conference. In the morning, 8 o'clock, I'll be meeting with the executive of the province. As soon as I'm done with the executive of the province, I'll be addressing the top management of the government in the Premier's office, after which I will be in a press conference to indicate the way forward beyond what I explained today. I think people did not understand me today, because maybe the way I put the expression was such that people did not understand it. But what I meant was that we are already beyond what people are thinking. This thing of resignation, we are beyond that already. So tomorrow, I'll just be explaining beyond this resignation what is going to happen going forward. So we are no longer speculating on whether there's a resignation or not. We are beyond that.
So does this then mean that we can say and report that the Premier of the Northwest will be handing in his resignation as the Premier of that province?
I'm saying we are beyond that. That is why I had indicated today that the Speaker will be receiving a letter. It's procedural. We must just follow what is in the Constitution. So that is what is delaying us. So, but we are beyond that already.
Premier, I'm sorry, but I'm going to push you a bit on this one. What do you mean that we are beyond speculating whether you will resign or not? If you have agreed, for instance, to speak to us this evening and you say that you are beyond, or we are beyond this speculation whether you resign or not, why wouldn't you come out and say that in the letter that you'll be sending to the Speaker later this week, that you will be indicating that you are indeed resigning?
I'm saying we are beyond speculations, because what is left is just to follow the administrative processes which are prescribed in the Constitution. So we can't stop thinking because we have not yet followed those particular processes. We are already thinking beyond those administrative processes. So as soon as I'm done with the executive tomorrow morning, there will be formal communication with the Speaker. But the details will be given tomorrow in a press conference.
Does this then mean that come the 2019 campaign, election campaign for the ANC, that Supra Mahumapelo may not be the Premier of the Northwest?
We are beyond that, Aldrin. I'm saying by tomorrow, midday, Supra Obakeng Ramoeletsi Mahumapelo will be the former Premier of the Northwest. That's what I'm saying. We are beyond that. We are living beyond what people are still perceiving, what people are speculating. That's why I'm saying what we need to follow is just the administrative processes which are prescribed in the Constitution, because I have to communicate with the executive tomorrow, the top management, and the Speaker of the Legislature. So where I'm sitting, my mind, my soul, and everything else is beyond those speculations. I'm in another world already.
Okay. Are you happy with whatever decision you have taken, that when you do write that letter, when you do have that meeting with the management of the province as well as the party as well, that you are satisfied that this would be the right decision that you've taken, not only for the party, but also for the people of the province?
Remember that in politics, we operate within the parameters of particular political circumstances. So it's not about you being happy or unhappy. The political circumstances create particular environments, and I will elaborate tomorrow on this particular environment and how I see them, and how, as a head of the movement, I will continue to play a role in the movement. So it's not about how you feel, but it's about certain political circumstances which get to be created or exist from time to time. And as a leader and a head of the movement, you have to respond accordingly. So I'm beyond that already.
Can you then confirm, Premier, whether the NWC has spoken to you and asked you to hand in your resignation letter?
It's not necessary for the National Working Committee to do that. As I say, we operate within particular political circumstances, and we need to respond to such political circumstances. I will not dwell into how I feel about those circumstances, but as we speak, objectively, we are in those circumstances. And therefore, I will elaborate tomorrow in the press conference why I believe a particular political narrative has been created so that we are in the circumstances where we have now reached a stage of untenability.
Premier, you speak about an environment, you speak about the conduciveness of being in the province, I guess, and perhaps this decision that you have taken, do you think that it has been exacerbated by the current infighting that's happening not only in the province but across the party? For instance, there was a day when you were addressing members, I think the community members of Kolini, where you said that there are people who are trying to oust those who supported Dr. Nkosazana Dlamini-Zuma ahead of the NASREC conference in December.
We are beyond NASREC already. And the president of the African National Congress and the collective of the National Executive Committee, based on the resolutions of NASREC, we have agreed that we must unite the organization, we must renew the organization, and we must build unity. But remember, unity does not happen like a bullet coming out of a gun. It's a very complex, difficult, protracted process. It's not for the first time that the ANC goes to conference, and beyond conference there are some difficulties. So it is up to us as leaders to manage those processes in a very responsible manner going forward. So I wouldn't want to elaborate on how I feel about those particular circumstances.
Premier, here's another one. Is your relationship, of course, with the former president, President Jacob Zuma, something that has been widely reported? Earlier this year, I think it was in March, apparently you had a meeting with the former president. And I want to find out from you whether you've had any discussion with him with regards to the battle or the challenge that you are facing inside the party and inside the province, and whether he knows perhaps of this decision that you have taken.
In the last meeting of the National Executive Committee, in the presence of former President Jacob Zuma, and in the presence of the current president, Cyril Ramaphosa, I stood up and indicated to the meeting, as I say, in the presence of President Zuma, former president, and I said, I have never met with President Zuma in my life. When I meet President Zuma, I will not hide it, because there's no reason for me to be meeting with him in secret, in private. He's still a member of the ANC in good standing. He's a leader of the African National Congress in his own right. He's a former president of the African National Congress. And I'm one of the people who believe that President Zuma, former, remains innocent until proven otherwise by due processes of the law. Unfortunately, in South Africa, we create particular narratives, and those narratives are meant to drive particular political agendas. And we find people guilty, even if before they go through those due processes of the law. It's unfortunate that those are the narratives we have created in South Africa. I don't need to hide when I meet President Zuma or when I meet the current president, President Ramaphosa. There's nothing illegal that we are doing and nothing that is against what the ANC stands for.
Like the former president, as you argued, he still remains innocent until proven guilty. And I guess the same is for you as well. Yet there are these allegations of corruption leveled against you. They've called you the invisible hand when it comes to contracts relating to the Gupta brothers, especially the Mediosa, contract. How do you respond to that, Premier?
I'm not the MEC for health. And I've been explaining this matter on several occasions. It's very strange that, yes, the Premier must hold MECs accountable. There are problems in a particular department, in the Department of Health, but people choose to focus on the Premier. Tomorrow in the press conference, I will elaborate more about particular political circumstances that get to be created so that particular narratives about certain individuals can be created in order to politically pigeonhole such individuals so that ultimately they are evaporated from the political scene. So tomorrow I will talk about that in more detail.
Final question, Premier, before I let you go. What happens to your position or your title as the chairperson of the ANC in their province?
Branches of the ANC elect chairpersons and other members of the officials and collectives of the PC in well-constituted conferences of the ANC. Our next conference as a province, constitutionally, is next year on the 14th of February 2019. So we shouldn't be thinking even about the position of chairperson. It doesn't arise at all.
And you wouldn't be able to indicate whether you will be available to be re-elected as chairperson?
Well, it's up to the branches of the African National Congress. You remember that I used to be a secretary for many years in this province, and the branches of the ANC then decided to make me chairperson. So if they say we still want you as a chairperson, I wouldn't say no. That's why I joined the ANC 35 years ago.
Okay, then. Thank you so much, Premier. And we look forward to that press briefing, as is indicated, that the press briefing will be taking place tomorrow morning. The SABC news channel here on 404 will be carrying that press briefing live to you as the Premier gives more details with regards to this decision that he has taken. And Francis, all indications are that he's resigning as the Premier of the Northwest.
Yeah, basically saying it, I will be former Premier by tomorrow. So there you have it on the SABC tonight. Supra Mahumapelo confirming that he will be stepping down in conversation there with Aldrin St-Pierre. He says the press briefing will be tomorrow. So maybe some more of his reasoning there, but denying the claims against him. All right, we stay with political battles, this time of a different kind, the battle between Patricia de Lille and